third man. First boundary for the England captain.
More runs down through that area and more frustration for Jason Gillespie.
That's a good shot. Whipped that one through mid-wicket. Won't quite get to the boundary, though. If ever there was an England batsman that needs some runs, it's the captain.
That's a lovely shot from Vaughan. That's just about Michael Vaughan at his very best. Well, it was in the air, but he flashed very, very hard. Michael Vaughan. And two slips in place and a fine gully who's very close.
Well, that's a better shot. The first one this over went for four, but it did go in the air, and that was a beautiful shot.
And dropped again! Dear, oh dear! It's flown, it was a toughie, but I have to say, you've got to get him. This time it's Michael Vaughan gets a life on 41.
No third man. Fast outfield. It's quick enough during the day. No one's going to get that. I like that. That was a beauty. Wasn't all that bad a delivery. McGrath had it slanting in just a fraction to Vaughan. And Vaughan had it slanting very quickly out to the boundary.
Oh, that's lovely batting. All you need to do is wait and wait on a pitch as true as this, and then you'll get your timing into sync.
Oh, it's a full toss, and he's hit it nicely. McGrath might not make this. He's struggling to get there. And he won't be running around there and putting his foot down just short of the rope, just in case he goes over on that ankle again. Right, that takes him to 99. He's got it away. That's well played. Listen to the roar. It goes up. That's Michael Vaughan's 15th century and his fourth against Australia.
What a way to bring it up. Lovely clip through the onside, and he will soak up this occasion. He's the first man in the series to bring up the three figures, and very timely that the skipper chips in. He's leading from the front now. His form has been an issue, but not now. He's turned things around.
That's a bit short and nicely played. That's what Vaughan should be waiting for.
Michael Vaughan is at his best. Maximum. Now that is extra special. You don't have to be good to do that. You have to be special.
I know it's two runs less than the six, but I think I like that more. A wonderful shot.
Wonderful timing.
Four more through the offside. Magnificent stroke from the England captain.
Good start, but an awful fall, that I fancy. Lovely crisp out of the middle of the bat, that was.
152, the England captain. Raises bat in acknowledgement and is finding his very, very best form now. goes again. Consecutive boundaries, three boundaries now off this over from Jason Gillespie. Jack! Nicely played, very clever from Vaughan.
Oh, this could have holed out. Yes. Well, a lovely, juicy full toss. And he smacked it straight down Longan's throat.
Can't believe it, Michael Vaughan. Big full toss from a part-time bowler, Simon Katic, and it's taken the strike bowler, Glenn McGrath, to show the rest of the Australian fielders how to catch. Vaughan could have picked his spot anywhere. He was looking for the deep mid-wicket boundary between the long on and the very square mid-wicket, and in the end he put it straight down Glenn McGrath's throat. But what an innings it's been, a timely return to form for the England captain. And the whole ground rises to him, appreciates his fluent stroke play and his mental strength as well, because he came into this innings under a little bit of a cloud. Wonderful innings, 166 to him, 290 for three.
Nice timing. Go for forward, beat the man at mid-on.
That's a good example of Ponting playing his natural game. Happy to take on the short ball from Flintoff.
Wonderful batting that. Ponting in complete control of the stroke.
And that three bringing up another half century in Test match cricket for Ricky Ponting.
Wasn't a bad shot, because the ball wasn't terribly short. And Ponting got himself in a very, very good position. I like that. If anything, that was an even better shot. It was played in more relaxed fashion.
It's where Ponting has played so well. It's another magnificent strike. And he's really just easing the ball there. Giles needs just be a fraction short and Ponting's onto it.
Oh, well played. Down the wicket he goes, and mid-on's a little wide, and that one's gone crunching into the boundary. Well, that's a beautiful shot, and that is Ricky Ponting's 100. It's running away down to the extra cover boundary. An elegant cover drive, Ponting's 23rd century, and it's his fifth against England. That's very well played.
It certainly is. Well played, skipper.
There's a splendid stroke. Ponting's got all his wits about him. And clearly his timing is still working beautifully.
Drill down the ground by Ricky Ponting. Even though he's been under the cosh today, he's taken every opportunity to put the bad ball away.
Oh, that's well played on the back foot. Ponting is playing beautifully. 150 for him.
Joy, imagine what Ponting is going through now. Steve Armisen has thrown everything at him and got him.
Well, he's really strangled him down the leg side. He's been trying to bowl him out round off stump. I don't know if it hit the glove or the, went along the face of the bat. No idea. Ooh, looks like glove.
Glove. It was the glove.
What a good decision again.
Amazing umpiring.
and he got his hands away from his body with a short ball, wanting the single. What an innings! The applause should last forever. The Australian captain has stood up and played one of the great rearguards.